Hey everyone, my name's Andrew from Film and Flourish, and this week's tip goes out to all you lovely vendors out there, and that tip is educate. Educating couples is a goldmine that I don't think every vendor is fully utilizing. Whether you are the hair and makeup artist, or the planner, the photographer, or the videographer, you're selling so much more than just your services, you are selling couples on you. I think a lot of us feel the pressure to conform to the industry standards of trying to sell people on our creativity, our work, and even our pricing. These are obviously all things that every couple will take into consideration, but how many of them will be booking us because we or you are someone they need at their wedding? This leads us to tip number one, anticipate wants and needs of your couples. One of the best ways you can serve your couple is not only answering their questions, but also teaching them things that they didn't know that they should know. They might have a list of questions ready to fire your way, but are unaware of some additional or even vital details and pieces of information regarding their wedding day. Answering their questions is good, but answering questions that they haven't even thought to ask is even better. The more value you can offer, the more likely they'll view you as a need for their wedding day. Which leads to tip number two, be transparent. Now this totally might be a personality thing where the extroverts get to shine and the introverts go running to the nearest rock to hide underneath, but transparency is one thing that will definitely separate you from the crowd. I think our industry often looks at things like money and payment plans as being taboo or insensitive, but I can name time after time when being open about those two subjects have convinced couples that not only was I worth what I charge, but that they could trust me. Being transparent and educating your couples doesn't mean you take hierarchy in the relationship, but more so builds trust and establishes your authority as a professional. When couples see, hear, and most importantly, feel those qualities, it makes you a need. Which leads us to our third and final point, invest in your couples as people before they're ever your client. Again, this might be a personal belief or a style of business, but I wholeheartedly believe that investing in your couple's lives in some way, shape, or form will lead to a stronger relationship and put you in a position to surpass all of their expectations. This isn't some planned out three-step plan to success, but I can say that when your couple feels taken care of and truly invested in, that feeling will reciprocate. It'll lead to a better experience on the wedding day and often leads to direct referrals from that couple. Now, even though this didn't make it into the final three tips, my last little piece of advice is to take this same mentality and bless the surrounding vendors you're working with. Reciprocity isn't just built within the relationships you establish with your couples, but also the people you work with. This point is mostly a shout out to videographers and photographers, since they're the two big positions that are working together side by side for almost the entire day. But when you can view the creative next to you as someone who's just as important as you or even more important than you, what you're communicating is a sense of humility and willingness to serve them in such a way that not only benefits both of you, but also directly and positively benefits your couple. I hope you find these few tips helpful, and I will see you again next week on Wedding Tip Tuesday.